No dance or drama.
Good evening, children. You may wonder why I have called all of you for the second assembly in the evening. There is a reason. You can see Mr. Vijay Kumar, Uday Kumar here. He is a techie. But he and sorry, some of his friends have joined hands for a human reason. They are doing a great service for Bangalore city. Have you heard of inscription? The word inscription? What is inscription? I will tell you. In olden days, if they were believed to have something to be written and stored for a long time, they used to write it on a stone, on the rock, or sometimes on a metal piece like a copper plate. And that was being seen for centuries. And the oldest inscription now, as we have learned in Kannada, Kannada script, is from Halmedi in the 5th century. Like that, you have all studied in your history, Ashoka has carved many inscriptions on stones. One is there near Chitradurga also. So, inscriptions are very much helpful for us to know the history of our country. Who was ruling, what was he doing and all. Now, I do not want to elaborate because you have to go for your buses. Now, I will come back to Bangalore. In and around Bangalore, there were around 152 inscriptions. There were, I am telling. Were in the sense, they are not there now. People have not, actually, they were not knowing the value of these scripts which are carved on the stones. What they have done is, they have broken the stones and used for some purpose. Maybe for the foundation of their houses. Somebody might have thrown it. Somebody making a road, they might have cut it. And there are different varieties. Veeragallu, a great soldier, a great warrior, when he was fighting, he might have died. And in his remembrance, people have carved his picture and they have placed it as a Veeragallu. On some Veeragallu, there will be only picture, like he was fighting and he was taken to heaven in a vimana, and later he sits and does puja for Sholinga, and his name and fame will remain as long as sun and moon are available. It is a pictorial story. But there are Veeragallus wherein script is also available. It is a very big subject itself. I cannot summarize the whole thing too short. But there are Masti Kallus also. You have heard of Masti Venkatesh Iyengar? Masti Kallu means a lady who has sacrificed herself, she has been glorified in that. So Veeragallu, Masti Kallu, and Danashasanas. Some king or somebody who donates some money for the temple or some land for the temple, he calls it, this is for this purpose, nobody should snatch away that land, something like that. So now out of 152 inscriptions, they have all been recorded in one book known as Epigraphia Carnatica. Can you remember the name? Epigraphia Carnatica. A great person, a foreigner by name Dr. B.L. Rice, he has started this work, going from village to village and making copy of it and doing research on that and finding out who did it and when did it, when he did it and what is the purpose also. Now, afterwards, another great Vidwan by name Narasimhachar and many more people have joined and done it, and even the archaeology department of India, they have also done it. Whatever it is, the details of Bangalore district is available in 9th volume of Epigraphia Karnataka. We have a few copies of Epigraphy of different districts in our school library. Some of them are reprint done by Mysore University. Whatever it is, out of 142, only less than 40 are still remaining. And we do not know when people are going to break them. Some of them are there in the drains, Pochemori. And some of them are there on the streets. Some of them want to build their houses, encroach the land. What they are going to do? They are going to break it. For the next, already we have lost so many, and for the next generations, those stones will not be there. Are they important or not? Are they important, children? Well, so these people, Mr. Uday Kumar and friends, they are trying to see that they are protected. For example, you can see one stone there. While going, you can see that stone names the city of Bengaluru. Bengaluru Kalabadal Sattam. One soldier died in Bangalore war. Who? His name is also printed there. But that is not the original one. Original one will be in the museum. That is found in Beguru. There is a temple, Nagalingeshwara temple. In that temple it is there. The date is 890 AD, almost 900 you can say. That is now it is the 21st century, more than 1100 years back. The name of Bengaluru is available there. That means Bengaluru was there even then. Can you understand that? Okay. But people say one story, just a legend. Veera Ballada was there, some Ballada was there, one king. He was thirsty. He went to, he was hunting. When he was tired, he went to one old woman. She gave him some Bendakalu. So the name of Bangalore has come from Bendakaluru. It is all burde. Because these such stories will always be there with everything. And history will not accept it. They want some proof, and proof of it there available in Begur Shasana or Begur inscription. You can read it. And how they print it? They will take a large sheet of paper. They actually immerse it in water, and the wet sheet they will just put it over the Shasana, press it, and then they will paint it with dark paint, and then the inscription will be there in white. The other portion will be in dark. You can also do it on Tuesday because you are not coming tomorrow. So, in the there are now new technologies available, laser printing and other things. They will also do it using those methods. And there is one more Shasana, one more inscription older than that in Hebbala. You know Hebbala flyover? When you are moving towards airport, there the name of the place Hebbala is mentioned. But then Ha was not being used in Kannada. They were using it as Pa. So the details you can get. I am not going to elaborate it. So now some people have, some architects have helped in making a small room-like structure. Architectural design they have made, and they are going to preserve that. You may wonder, there is one Shasana near Badrahalli here. Badrahalli. Among those 40 remaining. You know Badrahalli? Yes, near that Marama temple, there is one inscription. We would like to take some of you over there. So these are all the activities under our heritage club. So you must know the heritage of this country, and you should feel proud about it. Now I will come back. Tomorrow, your parents are coming for the parents' meet. Please inform them. There will be an exhibition of these things here. And there are lots of posters you can see, wall hangings you can see. There are more than 30 wall hangings, and they are related with different inscriptions of Bangalore. Some of them are in Tamil, because Bangalore is the place where many languages meet, Telugu, Tamil and Kannada. There, and Telugu may also be there, Kannada may also be there, and the details are also printed there. and tomorrow they are going to demonstrate how the print is taken. Now, they are now spending all the money from their pockets. And now they want to make replicas like this. Please show them. So this is the replica what they have done on an alloy. We can call it as brass plate. On this brass plate, what they have used the latest technology of printing it with lasers, using laser. So this they are charging about 2600 rupees. And they are selling it to interested people. So this could be gifted to somebody, this could be kept in the showcase. Instead of keeping so many things, this could be used. And if somebody will buy these things, they will be able to produce more and more copies like this. Of about 39, what is remaining in Bangalore, 39 or so. So there is no compulsion that everybody should buy. If at all they are interested, they can do it any day they like. Because they are not available immediately, they can order, they have to get it made, and then they can supply. Maybe it may take more than 30 days or even more. Now I have ordered about 6 copies for our school. So whatever it is, tomorrow you inform your parents, there is exhibition. When you are coming for the parents meet, please go through it and meet the people who are interested. On Tuesday, these people are again coming to enlighten you about these things. For a few people, they are going to demonstrate how the copies are being taken. They will allow the children to do the job themselves. Would you understand, children? So, this is all what I wanted to say. There is a lot more. But if you are interested more, you can come to us, go to your history teachers. They will be able to help you. Thank you very much. And it is already late. Slowly, that group, please move to your buses. Please.